So church, this is our instruction. This is our instruction. Church, please stay aware of what Satan's plans is for the church. You got to stay aware. You got to know that when you see Satan's fruits in the church, you got to rebuke that. You got to bind that up. You can't let that. But watch this now. When you do see Satan cutting up, you don't fight rail for rail. You know, the Bible, matter of fact, give me, back it up. See, if somebody cuts you out, you don't cut them back. Mm-hmm. When you see that devil real head, somebody says I'm smarter than you, or cut you, or says, tell you something, you know that the devil, when you recognize that devil, cast it. When you recognize, don't fight rail for rail. Don't get mad with him. Get what the scripture says. Because see, if you go rail for rail, if you go flesh to flesh, see what will happen. What's going to happen then? They don't pull you into the game. Now you're a part of the same plan. Amen. You're a part of his plan now. Because now, instead of you should not cut that sister back out or that brother out. You should have held your peace. Because the Bible says that the wrath of a man does not produce the righteousness of God. Back that thing up. The Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not what? Carnal. But mighty through God. For the pulling down of strongholds. Huh? So when you see devil cutting up, you fight him with the word.
Amen.
See, that brother that talking about you and backstabbing you in the church, you know who that is. That's Satan. Don't take that personal. That's Satan using that person. So what you do is pray for him. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who what? Spite on you. So what you got to do is, you got to do what Jesus did. When Satan started cutting up, when he had him in the wilderness, what Jesus did, it is written. Mm-hmm. Man should not live by bread alone, but by any word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. So what you got to do? Don't get no attitude back with him. Hold to his word. Because if you're going to fight like they fight, Satan got it way now. Mm-hmm. Because remember what I'm telling you now, his kingdom ain't divided. So you and that sister, that brother sitting there fighting and cussing each other, going back and forth. Get what Satan sitting back saying,
I got you now.
Look at him. Come here, demons. Look at him. Look. I told you I'd give him. Look at him. And get what, demons. Come here. Get what? These folks on us, bro. Look at him. Whoa, look at him. And all we do is make a mockery out of God's plan.
Amen.
So when somebody roll up on you, and you know the devil is influencing, because you know it when the devil rears his head.
Amen.
If you're spiritual, you know when he pop up, what you got to do. The Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God. For the pulling down a stronghold, casting down all imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity, into the obedience of Christ. Amen. So when you use the word, Satan got to get back there. Y'all know the scripture when it says over in James 4:7. Said, submit yourself unto the Lord. Resist the devil and he shall what?
Flee
from you. If you resist him, he got to move. He got to leave.
That's your truth.
But if you're going to fight with him in the way he likes you to fight, he got you. So therefore, church, watch this. Look at this last scripture. Look at what Paul tells us to do in Ephesians 5th chapter. 15th verse. It said, see then that you walk circumspectly. Stop right there. What does it mean by see then that you walk circumspectly? Somebody talk to him. See then that you walk
upright.
Circumspectly.
Upright and godly.
Mm-hmm. What you say?
Upright and godly.
Upright and godly. I'm looking for another word though. Well, what you say, Miss Susan?
I say it upright.
Okay. Anybody else? circumspect.
I think it means that you're supposed to walk like God in a sense. And then, you know, like, if God wants you to do this here, you do it. If the devil wants you to do it, look at the devil, poke your tongue out at
him. Yeah, that, you won't. You won't. Let me tell you what circumspect means. Walk.
Right, upright.
Upright, but aware. My mama always told me, getting out the yard, getting out the car in the yard. Tell her, when you get out the yard, little young boy, young man, you get out there, put that cell phone down. You get out that car, that cell phone side your ear, you get out in the dog yard, somebody bust you across your head. Oh, I don't know what you're talking about. One day I pulled up in the yard, had the cell phone to my ear, dude. Mm-hmm. Popped out. But yeah, man, so and so did that. My brother snuck behind my truck. I didn't see him. I was on the phone. Yeah! Man, what you do that for? I wasn't paying attention to my surroundings. See, as Christians, as believers in Christ, we get to walk in life as we walk and ain't paying attention. We got to look at our
surroundings. Be aware of that.
Got to be aware.
Yeah.
That devil is on the move, y'all.
He is that now.
That's why when you go to bed, spell it men folk. When you go to bed, don't you be the first one to fall asleep.
No.
When you wait till the whole house go to bed, then you get up and check the house. Check the window.
I check the door.
You check it yourself.
Check the door.
What I'm saying? Be aware.